Hi guys, welcome back to The Social Tune. And today, we're gonna count down the worst albums of 2018. However, this is gonna be a little bit different than last year. Because at least in my opinion, 2018 was not exactly a stellar year for music. And because of that, I handed out more low scores than I ever have before. To the point where it almost doesn't seem fair not to highlight, well, all of them. So, the way we're gonna do this is we're gonna go through them tier by tier, 4 out of 10s down to the inevitable zeros, name all of our contenders, and then name a crowning king for each of those categories. So rather than explaining it further, let's just dive in with the 4 out of 10s, the mediocre tier, the albums that are just plain bad. And there were plenty of albums in this category that could have taken it, believe you me. There was Mania by Fall Out Boy, easily their worst album to date, with that awful lead single Young and Menace. But to be fair, most of it is just kind of boring and generic and disappointing rather than outright awful. We had Nothing to Prove by Lil Yachty, where he's still trying to be a bunch of other MCs rather than his unique self. I could have given it to Delta by Mumford & Sons, but this is basically their third album in a row with the exact same problems, and at this point I'm just sick of it. For the controversial picks, I could have given it to Vertigo by Eden, an album and artist I still don't get the appeal of, or even My Dear Melancholy by The Weeknd, an entire project where he just whines about Selena Gomez with awful production, especially vocally. And the one that came the closest was definitely Speak Your Mind by Anne-Marie. But say what you will about Anne-Marie, her voice is definitely more pleasant to listen to than this guy's. I just took Cialis, but she on the Molly. Hey, hey, do you wanna put up, do you wanna party? Hey, hey, Molly's in the sunny, baby, let's get gnarly. Hey, hey. Well done, Kodak Black, you have won the Most Improved Award for 2018. Actually no, that would go to As It Is and their album The Great Depression. And even though this is an improvement, it still sucks. The only reason this is in the mediocre tier is because it has a little less of Kodak Black trying to defend his honor, as he mostly keeps that centered on the first track Testimony, which is easily the worst one on this album, and instead decides to focus on sucking his own dick, talking about how great he is. Pretty generic rap cliches where every single performer on this album easily outshines him. Seriously, I have no idea why we're still giving this guy a career. He's easily one of the worst musicians working today, and I'm not even talking about who he is as a person, because, well, we all know that. As an artist, he has practically nothing to say. Everything new he does bring to the table is stuff that I really don't want, and his voice is easily one of the most grating and punchable on the pop charts. So congratulations, Kodak Black, you easily take the top spot on the mediocre tier. And with that, let's move on to the 3 out of 10s, the terrible tier. The albums that are frankly just awful and probably should never have been made. And you know what, XXXTentacion fans? He's not getting this one. Question Mark was definitely an improvement over 17, and even though it was still trash with a bunch of unfinished songs and terrible production, I can at least say that as an artist, it was a step in the right direction for the guy. I could have given it to Drip Harder by Lil Baby and Gunna for basically doing a bunch of generic hip-hop cliches a fair bit worse than anyone else, but let's be honest, who cares about that project? I could have given it to the third installment of the Shrem Life series with Shrem by Ray Shrimmer, a triple album that was one of the biggest slogs to get through this year, but I can still say that it's the best of their albums so far. And hell, it's nowhere near as much of a slog as Scorpion by Drake, which in a stronger year would easily have taken this spot, but in the end it was down to one winner and three runner-ups. The Neighborhood for one of the worst written and worst produced albums of the year, that is until you compare it to America by 30 Seconds to Mars, which is just a train wreck on every single level. And finally, there was Gravity by Bullet for My Valentine, which is easily their worst album to date with some of the worst production and mixing that I have heard all year. But you know what? With all of those albums, I went into them expecting them to be bad. I didn't go into them with any shred of hope that they could possibly be decent, and I was absolutely right. With this one though, it snuck up on me. You know, for as much as Imagine Dragons have got thrashed on this platform over the years, apart from one or two awful songs, I've personally never hated them. I've always seen a lot of potential in some of their best hits like Radioactive and Shot, and even that last album, Evolve, despite having some awful cuts on it, did have enough songs that I gave it a light 6 out of 10, and I stand by that score. It's not a bad album. But when I put this on the first time, I was laughing all the way through, and not even a belly laugh at how funny it was. No, this was more a desperate, what the fuck am I listening to kind of laugh. I was just incredulous at the awful songwriting, the repetitive nature of the hooks and the verses, the fact that almost every single song on this album is about the exact same generic thing, the fact that I could see all of them being commercial jingles at some point, and easily their most cartoonishly awful collection of songs to date. To sum it all up, it says a lot when Natural, a song that has been thoroughly torn apart by almost everybody who's heard it, is easily the best song on this album. And yeah, if you haven't heard it, that's definitely a warning. Origins by Imagine Dragons definitely takes this spot. And now to move on to something a little bit easier, the 2 out of 10s, the atrocious tier. In most years, this is the lowest you would want to go. Even in 2016, a year that most people call one of the worst years in music, we didn't get anything lower than a 2 out of 10 in my opinion. And this year, we had two of them. And honestly, it wasn't even a contest. Sure, Day 69 by 6ix9ine is awful and samey sounding all the way through, with an aggressive frontman being the only thing that really props it up into being anything interesting, where the lyrics are just violent vitriol and the production isn't even worth commenting on, and they're so lazy they even have two versions of Gummo on this thing despite how short it already is. But no, even with all that, you all knew what was gonna take this. You know, a lot of people are calling Lil Xanarchy by Lil Xan the worst album of 2018, and I don't blame them at all. This is awful. It's borderline unlistenable. You have a bunch of guests who are barely trying, and then you have Ray Shrimmer as the only light in the darkness on this project. Think about it. Ray Shrimmer are the best part of this album, and everything else here is just awful. The production either sounds cheap or completely unfinished. The album frequently sounds absolutely horrendous with some of the worst hooks that you will hear all year. The repetition is egregious and there are too many questionable lines to count. And in the middle of all of it, you have Lil Xan. Completely devoid of any charisma or talent. He can't rap, he can't sing, he can't make you care about him. He was easily one of the worst new artists that we were given this year. And there is no reason at all for him to have a career. But with all that said, he did only get a 2 out of 10. Because say what you will about him, he's not exactly squandering his talent because he doesn't have any. Which brings us quite nicely to the 1 out of 10s, the goddamned hellish tier. The music that is so awful that there's barely a word to describe how bad it is. And you know what? I never thought that this guy of all people could possibly disappoint me. But if you want an example of someone squandering the measly little talent they have to absolutely terrible effect, well, it wasn't like I was gonna let 6ix9ine off the hook that easily. You know, say what you will about Day 69, it's making the best use of 6ix9ine that it possibly can. This guy has practically no talent, but he knows how to shout aggressively at a camera. He knows how to spit vitriol in a way that some people for some reason relate to. But on this album, he decided to go pop, and my god, is it awful. I could barely sit through this thing. I was so fucking bored. But I kept listening to it because I was also very, very angry. This is an entire album of a guy completely misunderstanding his appeal in the mainstream and just releasing a bunch of poppy rap songs that nobody wanted to hear. Seriously, who listens to this guy because they find him remotely likable? You're a terrible human being and you should stay behind bars. I'm putting aside any criminal acts that he may have committed in his life, including, need I remind you, sexually assaulting a 13-year-old. This is easily one of the most contemptuous albums to be released in 2018. It's a middle finger to his audience. One where he knows his appeal, but fuck it, he's just gonna make pop rap so he can possibly make a little bit more money. And it results in some of the worst music that you will hear this decade. To the point where I would even say Fifi with Nicki Minaj is not the worst song on this album. No, that would have to go to Baby, which is his attempt at a Latin crossover, which ends up being honestly the worst song that I've heard in 2018. I hate this man, I hate this album, and every single guest who contributed to this should be ashamed of themselves. There's practically nothing salvageable here. Yeah, one or two flows are okay, but that's about it. And in any other year, this would easily be the worst album of the year. However, right before 2019 came around the corner, one album actually managed to get, well, a 0 out of 10. That's right, we finally got to the tier that I don't even have a name for. It's so bad and so devoid of anything good that I honestly am speechless that it even exists. Previously, the only album I've given this coveted score to was Speed and Bullet to Heaven by Kid Cudi. And you know what? This is actually worse. Okay, let me get this out of the way right now. No, I am not blaming XXXTentacion for this. Obviously, it's his voice on this album, and I'm not a fan of his singing. But he was dead. Of course I'm not gonna blame him for this. He had absolutely no creative control here. No, the people I'm blaming for this are the studio hacks and managers and producers who got together, saw that this guy was still making money after his death, and thought, you know what? Let's profit off of that mourning public. And XXXTentacion fans, I don't know why exactly you would take this personally. Because this is not me attacking your favorite artist. This is me attacking the people who are puppeting his corpse in front of all of you for their own gain. And because they had so little to work off of to begin with, you get easily one of the most bare bones and lifeless projects in every sense of the word that I have ever heard. Of course this album isn't trying to convey any ideas or themes. Of course the lyrics are repetitive garbage, because all they're taking is random vocal snippets and demos that X left behind, and stretching them out and looping them, trying to turn them into music. With some of the cheapest production you could possibly imagine, one of the worst guest features that I have heard all year from Kanye West, and worst of all, they have the gall to try and make you feel something for this album. Like, they actually frame it as a swan song, as if to convince the public that they are dedicating this to XXXTentacion. But hell, if that were the case, you would have put this album out for free, wouldn't you? But no, instead, you packaged it up and sold it and had the gall to slap his name on it just because you knew it would sell more that way. This is just disgusting, and every single person who worked on this deserves to rot in hell for doing this. This was a guy who was shot and killed only a few months back. He was younger than me. And yet before his corpse was even cold, you were already beating it to see how much money you could get out of it. Fuck this album and fuck everybody involved in it. And those are the worst albums of 2018. Yeah, the format was a little bit different, but like I said, there was a lot that I wanted to shout out in this video. If you'd like to list your own more conventional top 10 list, feel free to leave that in the comments below. And don't forget to please hit that notification bell and subscribe so you don't miss a thing. And until the next time, I'm Finn, and this is The Social Tune, signing off. Happy 2019. No music, wait till the unhuns. My papa from that woman carried the future, and 20 was born like.